In this video, I'll show you how to create an NPS survey step by step. We'll go through all the ways in which you can modify and personalize your survey to make a truly custom experience for your respondents. How to create an NPS survey. First, set up a free Survicate account. Head over to our website or straight to the sign-up page. Choose your survey type. Your survey type is basically how you want to distribute your survey. In Survicate, you have four options: email and link, website or in-product, mobile app, or Intercom chat survey. Next, find the NPS template in the survey library. You can create any survey from scratch, but it's best to start with a template. You'll be able to edit or modify any aspects of your survey. The NPS template is the first one on the list. When you click Use this template, all of the questions will be uploaded automatically. Go through all the copy and insert your company name into placeholders. And really, if you're crunched for time, you could just send the survey now. Just head over to the Share tab and launch your survey. How you do this will depend on the type of survey you made. For email and link surveys, you can either copy the link and share the survey with your respondents, or you can use the code to paste into your ESP. If you made a website survey, you will need to install the tracking code. You can do this with a one-click installation. Go over to Survey Settings and then Web Surveys. You can simply type your developer's email into the box and send the instructions, or you can install the code yourself. If you use Google Tag Manager, you can use the one-click installation available in your account, or find the Survicate plugin inside GTM. We also have a WordPress plugin, and you can also install the code with the Segment integration. You can also install the tracking code manually. If you made a mobile app survey, you'll need to install the Survicate SDK in the native app code. You can find the mobile SDK developer documentation in our help center. You can also click the question mark at the top of your Survicate panel and go to developer docs. If you made an Intercom messenger survey, go to the Connect tab and add the integration. You'll find further instructions in the Launch tab of your Intercom survey. And it's that simple. Once you've shared the survey with your customers, you can just wait for responses, and you'll be able to see all of them in the Analyze tab in the dashboard. The template is set up with survey logic, and the follow-up questions, or the responses to the follow-up questions, will be automatically sorted into your detractors, promoters, and passives. But more on that later. To prove to you that Survicate really is the best NPS software, I'll show you some more things that you can do in our tool to really personalize your survey and your respondents' experience. Format your questions. You can customize the way your questions and responses look by using bolding, italics, links, and images in your survey. You can also add introductions to your questions. You can even add a separate introduction for each question, where you can give more information, for example, about the purpose of a question or include instructions. Modify questions. You can change the copy of any question and answer choice inside any template. You can also add or remove questions. But before adding any extra questions to the template, think about all the things that you can collect automatically. For example, it makes no sense to ask for an email address when you can just collect it as an attribute. You can also modify the template with information recalling. So, for example, the follow-up question or the introduction to that question could recall information from the NPS question, and that way the respondent's experience will be more personalized. You can also add a fallback if the information recalling isn't working for whatever reason. You can do this by clicking and just typing in your fallback. Choose an existing survey theme or create your own. You can use your own image as a background or add one from the Unsplash library. You can also go through our designs. On the top right, you can also check what the NPS survey will look like on different devices. Modify the email template. If you made an email and link survey, you can modify the email template. You can add your logo or change the button style. Add alternative language versions. To make sure your data is as accurate as possible, add alternative language versions to your survey, especially if you operate on an international market. To do this, go to the Create tab of your survey and click on Translations. A pop-up window will appear where you can select which languages you want in your survey. You can select more than one at a time. You can click on Manual Translation and type in question and answer choices yourself, or choose a Google Translation. I recommend choosing Automatic Translation. You can edit any fields afterward. Toggle between language versions here. You can also delete a language by clicking on the bin icon next to it. If you don't add the language a respondent's browser is set to, they'll see the original version of the survey you created. Note, you can only add multilingual features to LinkedIn email surveys and website surveys. Redirect promoters to boost your reviews and ratings. You can add a special flow for your promoters and invite them to leave a review on a third-party site. One of our customers, Card, did this exact thing with their NPS survey, and they were able to easily go from 4.2 to 4.8 on Trustpilot. To do this, click on Add Question and choose Thank You Message. Let's write, "We're so happy to hear that. Would you mind leaving us a review on G2? Then go to Settings and add a copy to your button. Here is where you can paste the link to your G2 profile. Then go to Survey Logic in the first question and make sure you send promoters straight to the thank you message. Unless you want them to follow up as well, then add logic to the follow-up for promoters. Configure your survey. After you are done with the microcopy and appearance of your survey, you'll be able to configure the output. Set up respondent identification. You'll have to do this with a tool like MailChimp. Decide whether your respondents will be able to retake your survey. Enable or disable your survey. Set a response limit. Or set up an end date for your NPS survey. Connect with your favorite tools. The Connect tab is all about Survicate integrations. At the moment, we have 23 native one-click integrations. You can also use Zapier to integrate with tools you don't find on the list. Let's connect with Slack as an example. Find it on the list and click Connect. All you have to do is sign into your workspace. You can even set up custom notifications to a preferred Slack channel. So let's make sure we are notified each time there is a new NPS detractor. We have Slack connected, and let's toggle Send Notifications to Slack. Choose a channel where you would like to receive notifications, enable custom notifications, and set up rules. So we want to get a Slack message each time a respondent identifies themselves as a detractor, so if they choose a rating between 0 and 6. To do this, choose Question and Answer, select the NPS question, and the condition will be between 0 to 6. And let's fill out the NPS survey as a detractor to see what happens. So we copy the link, open it in a new tab, let's choose 0, and I have a new notification on Slack. This is what such a notification may look like. You can also set up custom email notifications, and it works very similarly. Find email notifications on the list of integrations. Enable them and set up your rules. Once more, let's be notified about NPS detractors. And let's fill out the survey again as a detractor. And we got a new email. And here is what such an email notification may look like. The next step is to analyze your NPS results. Your NPS results will populate in the dashboard in real time. You'll have a ready and up-to-date survey report at all times. To find your report, find your survey in the library and click on Responses. You can also simply go to your Analyze tab inside the survey view. For every survey you collect, you'll have the total number of responses, dates of those responses on a chart, the date of the last response in the UTC time zone, your completion rate, basically how many people answered all of your questions, your survey views, and the actual responses to your questions. But most importantly, Survicate has a built-in NPS calculator. A visual report will appear in your Analyze tab, showing your net promoter score and distribution. It will update with each new response. The Survicate survey report is very interactive and user-friendly. You can sort data right here without needing to use any spreadsheet software. For example, you can sort the data to only see responses from your detractors. You can also use filters to sort data by date, answer, or respondent attributes. You'll be able to collect key demographics such as email address, name, and browser information if you configure a distribution method. Watch our survey report video to discover all the features in this tab. Export NPS data. Let's also have a look at exporting your results. At the top right of your survey report, you'll have a button to export results to XLS or CSV format. You can also download results to each question to PDF or PNG.